Very good morning. Today I am going to show the demo of login system or how to check the user authentication using PHP and MySQL in XAMPP server. So XAMPP abbreviation means X means any operating system, A means Apache, and M means MariaDB, P means PHP, and another P means Perl. So I have already installed XAMPP in my laptop. So go to this start option. You can just click X. You can see this XAMPP control panel. Very first thing, you have to start this Apache and MySQL using this start button. So I have clicked this start button. You can see the status change detected is running. Now Apache is running. Then after that, you can see this MySQL also running. So you can see here status change detected, MySQL is running. Then after that, what you have to do is you have to create a database. For that, what you have to do is to check whether this XAMPP is running, you have to put or you have to type it in the URL. Just type http://localhost, or you can type localhost. So if you are getting this XAMPP Apache MariaDB PHP Perl information, means you can confirm that your XAMPP server is running. So what I am going to do is I am going to create the database. So for that I have to put localhost php my admin. So you can use this option. Another option is you can just click this XAMPP control panel and you can click this admin. That will also take you to that php my admin. So this is a way to enter into your MySQL database. I have already have the database called Anand. So I have already created. So, and I am having one table already, that is called registration table. So creating database is very simple here. You can just click new database and you can type your database. Here I am having the database name called Anand. There I am going to create a new table. So this is a requirement. So I am going to create a new table. So I am going to give the table name as login. How many field I am going to have? Two field I am going to have. Just click go. So I am going to create a very first field is username. For that I am creating username shortcut as uname. Data type is varchar and I am giving length as 15. Then password I am going to create again as pwd in short form. That is also varchar data type. So I can give the password as 15. So you can see here I have created the new table under the database called Anand with two field, username and password, and I have to give the value. For that just click this SQL. So just click insert. I am giving the value for my username and password. I am giving value as Anand and password is 1234. So after that click go. If you want to add another value, you can just remove this ignore button. You can add another record. So I want only one value to be inserted here. So just click SQL and you can just click select star. So it is to see your values in your table. So I am having the values Anand and 1234 as password in my table. So now we have to write the PHP coding. So I am closing this one. So I need three files for executing my PHP program. I mean coding. So I have created a folder called htdocs. So this is where you have to save all your files. So C colon. Here only I have installed my exam. So under that exam folder, so under your htdocs hypertext documents, so I have created the folder called demo. You can see here I am having one HTML file and two PHP file here. So very first thing, I am going to see the HTML file. I will show the coding now. So this is very simple HTML file. You can see the coding here. So one title, login system. Here you can see body, background color is apple green. So H1 header, it is nothing but login. Then you have new form. Form name is equal to F1. Action is equal to login.php. On submit, return validation method is equal to post. So very simple meaning. Here it is. When the user is clicking after entering the username and password, when the user is clicking that submit button or save button, so I have given here that particular button name is as login. When the user is clicking the login button, that login.php file has to execute. So you know very well why we are using post and get method. Both the methods are used to send the values from form to database. So here input type is equal to text. So ID is equal to user, name is equal to uname. This is very, very important. What is the field name which you have given in your database or in the table, and same name you have to give here for the name also in this particular HTML. So second field, input type is equal to password, ID is equal to pass, name is equal to PW. So here you can see the password as label. Another one is username as label here. Then after that, input type is equal to submit. So one button, it is ID is button, value login. Input type is equal to submit, ID is equal to button, value is equal to cancel. So this is a small simple coding for two labels, text box, and two button, login and cancel. So I have to save this particular file as login.html. Save as, so demo folder exam htdocs demo. I have to save this particular file as login.html. So you have to select all files. The next file is, so already I have saved. So next file is, it is your connection.php. So the connection, we can save it as a separate file. So that can be used for all the database program. So very simple coding, you can see here this connection coding. So less than symbol, question mark, php, host. What is the server name? So $host is equal to your server name. How you are accessing the server? By using localhost. Dollar user, what is the username? Root. So I have created the demo folder, that is my root directory here, that is nothing but root. Password, I am giving it as empty. So database name, db underscore name. So you can, you know very well, dollar, it is nothing but user defined variable. We have to always declare the variable with the with dollar symbol in PHP. So dollar database underscore name is equal to Anand. So the database name which I have created, so in the MySQL, so that is nothing but Anand. Dollar connection is equal to MySQL I underscore connect. So in WAMP server, we use only MySQL underscore connect. Here we have to use MySQL I underscore connect. Within bracket, you have to mention the server name host, then username root, then password is empty, and database name is Anand. So if there is an error, so if MySQL I underscore connect underscore error number, then die. So you are throwing the error message. If it is not able to connect, failed to connect with MySQL. And this dot is nothing but concatenator in PHP. So MySQL underscore MySQL I underscore connect underscore error, which is used to retrieve the message why it is not able to establish the connection. Then after that, you have to save this particular file as connection.php. So connection.php. So save as all files, connection.php. So already I have saved. So then last file you need to have, it is nothing but login.php. So login.php coding you are going to see, it is very simple. Already we have written the coding for connection. So only login.php coding we have to see. So this is very simple coding. So question mark PHP is meant for, this is meant for PHP. Then include connection.php, that is you are written separately the particular file connection that you are including in this particular script. Then username, dollar username is equal to dollar underscore post of username. That is you are going to run this program by using the form. So when you are running this particular script, you are going to see the output. So I am just, you have to execute localhost slash demo. Demo is your root directory, localhost slash demo. So execute login.html. So you can see the form here, login, username, text box, password, text box, login button, cancel button. The value which I am going to enter is, I can capture by using, I am giving the value as Anand. I can capture this particular value by using dollar underscore post of uname. Again, I can capture the value which I am entering in this particular form. I am typing my user password as 1234. So since we have mentioned 1234 in password, it is not showing the text. It is showing as dot, or sometimes it will show as star. Now this password can be captured by using dollar underscore post of pwd. So capturing the values from the HTML form and show it in a new variable called uname. Capturing the value of your password from the HTML form and show it in a particular field called dollar pwd. Then after that, dollar SQL. So you are going to execute the SQL query. For that, dollar SQL is equal to select the values. So select star from means select all the values from the particular table called the login where username is equal to name must be the value which I have already captured by using HTML and I have stored in my $uname variable. So it is nothing but you are comparing the values which you are entering in your HTML form with the values already stored in your table. So in the table I have already stored the value, so that value is Anand, password is 1234. I am comparing the value with the table values. So that is this particular line. After that, result $result is equal to MySQL I underscore query. This MySQL and I underscore query, which is used to execute the query which I have given here. How I am going to execute? Using the connection. So in my connection, already I have written the connection script separately by specifying the username, password, server name, database name, everything I have given here in this particular $connection. So using that, I have to execute this SQL query. Select star from login where uname is equal to $uname and password is equal to $password. The next line, $row is equal to MySQL I underscore fetch underscore array. So this query select all the values and store it in a variable called result. And the next line, so from the result, all values are there in the result, and that result going to be fetched in the form of rows and column. That is the meaning of this function MySQL I underscore fetch underscore array, which is going to fetch all the values in the form of rows and columns. So $count is equal to another variable is equal to MySQL I number of rows of result. That means if any one row is found in this particular count, then your value is there in the table. We should understand value is there in the table. If $count is equal to 1, then you are displaying the message login is successful. That is, both the values in the table and in the HTML form value, both are equal, username and password, both are equal, means it will return the message login successful. If both are values are equal, username, password, if both the values are equal, then only the count value become 1. So if it is 1, it will display the message login successful. Else, it will display the message login failed, invalid username or password. Then after that, you are closing the PHP tag by using the question mark greater than symbol. Now I am going to execute the program. So again, refreshing for each and every change, you have to refresh. So I am entering the username and password. I am giving username as Anand and password as 1234 and click the login button. I am getting the message login successful. So another scenario, again I have to refresh and I have to execute login.html. I am giving my username as Anand, password is 2345 I am entering. So I am just clicking this login button. I will get the error message login failed, invalid username or password. Login failed, invalid username or password. So again, another scenario, I am going to give the password correctly, 1234, and I am giving username as Anand Raj. So login failed. So when I am giving the correct value, I'll get the message login successful. So I am giving again Anand. Password as 1234. Clicking the login button. So I'm getting the message as login successful. So I hope this will be useful for you to learn. So thank you so much for your patient listening.